ستارت بلش اوكي. السلام عليكم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه ولا. Today we will talk about the gas turbine engine. That's me, your instructor today, engineer Khalid Fawair. First, you have to understand or you have to put in your mind two main things. To study or to be an aircraft engineer or technician of an aircraft, you have to study first the Newton's law of motion and the behavior of the gases as it flow through a constant or non-constant cross-sectional duct. First, we will talk about the Newton's first law. First law of motion said that a body at rest tends to stay at rest, and the body at motion tends to stay in motion in a straight line unless caused to change as it is by an external force. يعني الجسم الثابت يبقى ثابت، الجسم المتحرك يبقى متحرك ما لم تكون ومتحرك في خطه المستقيم، ما لم تأتي هنالك قوة لتغير من الاتجاه أو من مقدار هذه السرعة. The second law of motion says that the acceleration of a body is directly proportional to the force causing it and inversely proportional with its mass. Force equal, that means force, F represent the force, equal mass multiplied M, mass multiplied by acceleration. Okay? Force represents the thrust that produced by the engine. The thrust produced by the engine. Okay? But, and the third law of motion said that here we have the third law of motion. The third law of motion said that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. لكل فعل رد فعل مساوي بالمقدار معاكس له بالاتجاه. Each of us have a balloon in some day. And when he releases his balloon, this is a balloon filled with gas. And when you release the balloon, here the gases will go down. This is the action. The balloon will goes up, this is a reaction. The balloon will goes up, this is a reaction. So, this is the laws of motion. Newton's first, second, and third law. Now, as I said, you have to study the behavior of gases. You have to study the behavior of gases at its flow through a non-constant cross-sectional duct. What is meant by non-constant cross-sectional duct? This is a constant cross-sectional duct. That means the diameter of the inlet equal the diameter of the outlet of this duct. مدخل هذا الفراغ أو هذا العمود أو هذه الأسطوانة نصف قطره أو قطره يساوي قطر المخرج. But in non-constant cross-sectional duct, the inlet of the duct is greater than the outlet, or the outlet of the duct is greater than the inlet. If we have a duct that it is diameter directly, or if its diameter is progressively decreased as we go from front to the back, this duct known as convergent duct. In a convergent duct, it is a fixed geometry duct. Its is diameter progressively decrease from front to the back. هو عبارة عن شكل هندسي. القطر تبعه يتناقص كل ما مشينا من الأمام للخلف. يتناقص كل ما مشينا من الأمام إلى الخلف. في حين إنه divergent duct is a fixed geometry duct. It's a convergent
okay? While this is a divergent. The divergent duct, it is a fixed geometry duct, while its diameter directly or progressively, progressively increase, يزيد يعني, when we move from front to the back. So, any fluid, flow through a hollow convergent duct, i.e. fluid that means liquid or gas, any fluid that flow through a hollow convergent duct, its pressure will decrease while its velocity will increase. Its pressure will decrease while its velocity will increase. And if any fluid that flow through a divergent duct, any fluid, that means liquid or gas, if flow through a divergent duct, its velocity will decrease while its pressure will increase. This is true when the air flow through these ducts in a subsonic speed and pillow. هذا الحكي تمام التمام وصحيح إذا هالغازات flow through these ducts when it is in a subsonic speed and pillow بسرعة تساوي أو تقل عن سرعة الصوت. لكن إذا كانت الغازات تسير بسرعة أعلى من سرعة الصوت because the air is incompressible, because the fluids is incompressible, the idea here will it becomes a different story. That means if the fluid هذا الحكي تمام التمام كل متى in subsonic speed, but in supersonic speed, any fluid that flow through a convergent duct, its pressure will increase while its velocity will decrease, and vice versa. Also, we still talking, or till now, we're talking about fluid that flow through a divergent duct in a supersonic speed. Here, the velocity will increase and the pressure will decrease. We will talk about this in supersonic speed. We will talk about this idea independently and in details. Now, just you have to know that any fluid flow through a convergent duct, any fluid flow through a convergent duct in a subsonic speed, its pressure will decrease while its velocity will increase. And any fluid that flow through a divergent duct in subsonic speed, its velocity will decrease while its pressure will increase. علماءنا الأفاضل استفادوا من نيوتن's third law when they talking about the rockets or when they manufacture a rockets. So, if you see a rocket or if you saw a rocket in some day, it is like a bullet. It is a cylindrical duct. عبارة عن جسم اسطواني مدبب. So it filled with two cylinders معبأ باسطوانتين. One is oxygen and the other is fuel. Here. And it has a source of and ignition. We have two bottles. One is oxygen. And the other is a fuel. If you recall any burning, it needs oxygen, a flammable material, and a source of ignition. Here in the rocket, we have two bottles. One filled with oxygen and the other filled with a fuel. And we have an ignition source. When the fuel mixed with the oxygen and ignited by the igniter block, here we have a fire and explosion. It's closed from the front and open at the rear. That means the gases will go down. This is the action The rocket will move up. This is the reaction. And this is what Uncle Newton said. Any force acting on a body, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Any force affected at the body, it has a reaction. It must be equal and opposite reaction. So, from this idea, from the rocket, they looking to have a gas turbine engine or a ramjet engine. The ramjet engine require an initial forward motion. That means it is not. If you recall in our shop, we talking about the gas turbine engine. It has a starter. It may be a pneumatic starter or it may be an gas turbine unit GTU or it may be an electrical or pneumatic starter. See here, but at the beginning, they do not know or they do not have an idea how to start or to drive or to motor the engine. The first, the jet engine is a duct, hollow duct. In jet engine, it is a hollow duct. There is no, that means no internal moving part. So, it's a fuel injection. And we have an ignition source. Here we have an oxygen comes from Allah, but from atmosphere, mixed with the fuel. يختلط مع الوقود. When it's mixed, it becomes a mixture and it's ready to burn. So, when the ignition take place, when the igniter plug ignite the fuel air mixture, that means the ignition take place, the burning take place. This will be a big burning. It's difficult to go back to the aft. So it will goes backward. This is the action. The engine with its vehicle goes forward. This is the reaction. So, if you recall, I said there is no moving part inside this engine. How the air enters the engine, that it needs an initial movement or initial forward motion. This engine, at the beginning, they pulled forward. كان يسحبون للأمام by some idea, electrical motor with a rope. They pull it from the back, from one from the side and one this side. They push it forward. So it needs the initial motion. When it's pushed forward, the air will comes or forced. The air will force to enter this cylinder. Mixed with the fuel, burned. Now, when it's burned, it goes back to the atmosphere as an exhaust gases. This is the action. Now there is no need to continue pushing the engine forward. The engine will go with its vehicle forward. This is the reaction. No. This is the beginning. After that, they try to have or they try to find another idea to let the engine accelerate without an external forces such as rope by electrical motor or by a human assist. So they looking to find an engine known as a pulsating engine. Pulsating engine, it is simple and his idea, here at the end, at the beginning of, at the forward, sorry, at the forward of the engine, at the engine inlet, They has a spring-loaded flappers. Spring-loaded flappers. It's closed by spring load. It's closed by, or open, sorry. It's opened by spring load. The air comes inside what? From the outside to the inside. When the explosive current out, they force this flapper to close. So there is no air will go back to the atmosphere or outside the engine from the inlet. All of the air will exhaust it from the exhaust section. When the effect of the explosive released or goes, they will open again. And the air will enter the engine again. After the burning, by an explosive force, overcome the spring load and close the flappers. The engine will open and close, open and close. So the motion like a pulsating. متقطعة راح تكون الحركة. Because of that, they known as a pulsating engine. Turbojet or turbojet engine introduction. Now we will talk about a gas turbine engine. The idea of the gas turbine engine. This is in 1931. أجانا واحد وأعطانا new idea, new information, new design of a pulsating or a jet engine. ولما طوروها, when they developed this idea, it known as a gas turbine engine. Gas turbine engine. هذا Mr. Frank. If you remember, I said it is when we're talking about the jet engine, we said it is a hollow cylinder, hollow duct. But the turbojet engine, the same duct, it has an inlet and outlet, but it has some moving parts inside it, such as an impeller or compressor, shaft, and turbine. Compressor, an impeller rotate around an axis. This impeller connected with a shaft with the turbine. So we have a starter. It may be electrical or pneumatic or gas turbine unit starter. هذا في المستقبل صار يتكونون. And here in the starter installed in some way by a gearbox. The starter, it is an electrical motor. If it is an electrical starter. Electrical motor, يعني زودوا بكهرباء بعطيك حركة. It converts electrical energy to an mechanical energy. When it is rotate, this shaft also rotates, so the main shaft will rotate. When the main shaft rotates, the compressor start to move clockwise or counterclockwise. Basically, it rotates clockwise. So now the air comes from atmosphere, the ambient air. When it enters the engine, it's forced under enough pressure to a combustion chamber here. In combustion chamber, we have a fuel injection and igniter plug. It burns and goes back to the turbine section. It strikes the turbine in a proper angle and the turbine starts to rotate. If the turbine rotates, the compressor also rotates because they're connected with the same shaft. After that, the gases goes back to the atmosphere. This is the action. The engine with the aircraft will move forward. This is the reaction. It can be started with stationary on the ground without initial forward speed. More speed. ما بحاجة إلى إنه يكون في داخله. ما بش بحاجة إلى إنه ندفعه
وهو فقط يعتمد على ستارتر حتى يدفع يحرك الكمبرسر. سو بعد ما يدور الكمبرسر هسه بنشوف شو التطورات اللي صارت بالتيربو جيت انجن. Now we will talk about the gas turbine engine. Before we talk about the gas turbine engine, let us to talk quickly about the reciprocating engine. In the reciprocating engine, we have a cylinder. Inside the cylinder, we have a piston connected with the crankshaft by a connecting rod. Here we have an fuel air mixture source, اللي هو نسميه ال inlet valve. Here we have a valve to purge the exhaust gases to the atmosphere. الآن بسرعة, as the crankshaft rotates by a starter, it takes the piston downward. This will allow the fuel air mixture to enter inside the cylinder. This stroke known as an inlet stroke, when the piston moves from top dead center to the bottom dead center. When the piston reaches top dead center, the intake valve will close. After that, the piston continues to travel to go from bottom dead center to the top dead center. Piston بتحرك لأعلى مجال ممكن يوصله, وبالتالي the fuel air mixture will be compressed. When it is compressed, here we have an igniter plug to build the fuel air mixture. When it is burned, it expands and pushes the piston again downward to the bottom dead center in a power stroke. After that, the exhaust valve will open and purge the burned gases. This is a quick information about the reciprocating engine. But our lesson talks about the turbine engine and how it works. The turbine engine, we have a one cylinder, but it is not empty. Okay. We have a compressor. Then we have a combustion chamber. After that, we have a turbine. We have a compressor. Now, the air comes from the air inlet. The air inlet, it is a duct. The main function of the air inlet to recover as much of the total air pressure from the free air stream as possible and deliver it to the compressor. Here, the air comes from Allah, from the atmosphere, recovered by the air inlet as possible and delivered to the compressor. The compressor, it is a rotating part. And we'll talk about the compressor independently. It consists of a rotor and a stator. Okay, the moving part is a rotor. It accelerates the air and pushes it back to the combustion chamber. Briefly, the compressor forces the air under enough pressure and delivers it to the combustion chamber. Here in combustion chamber, with the air forced to the combustion chamber under enough pressure, it's mixed with the fuel.
The combustion chamber is the place where air and fuel mixed and burn. The combustion chamber هو المكان الذي يتم خلط وحرق الهواء والوقود. Here we have also an igniter plug to ignite the fuel air mixture. Okay. When the fuel air mixture burns, it expands and goes back to the turbine section. It strikes the turbine section at a proper angle. So the turbine starts to rotate. When the turbine rotates, the compressor also rotates. After that, the gases goes or the gases go back to the atmosphere. This is the action. The turbine engine will take the aircraft forward. This is the reaction. This is the reaction. مرة أخرى. إحنا الهواء it comes by Allah from the atmosphere through an air inlet duct. The air inlet duct it is a duct just to recover as much of the total air pressure from the free air stream as possible and deliver it to the compressor. In compressor, the air forced under enough pressure and delivered to the combustion chamber. In combustion chamber, it mixed with the fuel and burn. It expands. Its kinetic energy will increase and goes back to the turbine to strike the turbine at a proper angle. When the turbine rotates, the compressor also rotates and the gases leave the engine to the atmosphere. This is the action. The aircraft will move forward. This is the reaction. هذا الحكي بدنا نمسحه مش مشكلة نرجع نرسه مرة ثانية ولكن حتى نشوف شو صار في الهواء اللي دخل على المحرك وبعدين نتكلم كيف دار المحرك كيف بدأت الحركة ومن وين دور المحرك الـ first start or initial movement.
ستة بس
ها؟
ستة
شو ستة؟
شاهدة
Now when this is the volume of the air and here is the pressure of the air the volume and the pressure خلينا نشوف شو العلاقة وشو اللي قاعد بصير معانا كل ما تحركنا الخلف الآن هاي الغاز تربان ينجن Compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, and exhaust. Then, when the air enters the air inlet, it is from the atmosphere, from Allah. It is maximum volume. كان في أقصى هاي الفوليوم. إحنا كل ما تحركنا بهذا الاتجاه صار عندي زيادة. الآن, the air comes from atmosphere and enters the engine. When enters the engine, it is volume will start to decrease, progressively decrease. Decrease, but in a slow rate. And when it reached the compressor, it forced under enough pressure. So, its pressure will increase while its volume will decrease. In combustion chamber, when the gas burned, its pressure slightly decreases and its volume starts to increase. And when it leaves the combustion chamber to the atmosphere through an exhaust, it expands, its pressure will decrease rapidly, and its volume will increase to its max limit through the space. مرة أخرى. هنا we have two vectors, the volume and the pressure. In X side, the volume and the in Y side we have a pressure. From atmosphere, the air goes to the air inlet. Its pressure directly or smoothly increase and its volume progressively decrease when it reach to the compressor. It start to compress, the pressure will increase and to reach to the max, while the volume will decrease to reach to the max. Here, the pressure will reach to the minimum, the pressure will reach to the max, while the volume will reach to the minimum. In combustion chamber, when it burn, it expand, and its pressure will reach, start to rapidly decrease, or progressively decrease, and its volume will start to increase. In exhaust section, when it goes back to the atmosphere, its pressure will rapidly, dramatically decrease, and its volume will start to increase to its max. Now, let us to name down the main parts of the gas turbine engine and how these parts operate with each other. First, we have a compressor. Regardless how many stage, and here we have a turbine. Between each of them, we have a combustion chamber. Now, the first part of the gas turbine engine known as air inlet, the first part of the gas turbine engine known as an air inlet. The second part known as a compressor. The third part is the exhaust section, is the combustion chamber. Combustion chamber. Here we have a turbine, and we have an exhaust. So, by an electrical mean or pneumatic starter or gas turbine unit starter, we have a shaft connected in an engine gearbox. Electrical starter, it is an electrical motor. It converts electrical energy to mechanical energy. As it rotates, when the pilot or the engineer push the push button or starter push button, we energize the starter. So when the starter rotates, connected with the main shaft by through a shaft, the compressor starts to rotate, and the air comes from the air inlet, start to enter the engine. The air inlet, it is, or inlet duct, it is a fixed geometry duct. It may be a convergent duct or convergent divergent duct. We will talk about each part independently. But as a basic, it is a duct, fixed duct. When the air comes by from Allah or from atmosphere, the air inlet duct recover as much of the total air pressure from the free air stream as possible and deliver it to the compressor. in compressor. As the starter rotates, the compressor also rotates. The compressor compress the air or force the air under enough pressure and deliver it to the combustion chamber. In combustion chamber here, the incoming air, the incoming air now mixed with the fuel that comes from the injection and ignites through by an igniter plug. When it is burned, the potential energy here converted into a kinetic energy by expanding the burned gases. The burned gases goes back to a turbine section. It strikes the turbine at a proper angle, so the turbine rotates. As the turbine rotates, the compressor also rotates because they connected with each other by the same shaft. After that, the gases goes back to the atmosphere. This is the action. The aircraft will move forward. This is the reaction. As you see here, the engine divided to the two main sections. The cold section, منطقة الباردة, it is built from the air inlet and the compressor. And the hot section consists of the combustion chamber, turbine, and exhaust. It is a single spool engine. It is a single spool engine. That means it has only one compressor, regardless how much how many stages in the compressor, and one stage of the turbine, regardless how many turbine disks. Compressor, combustion chamber, turbine. But in some engine, we have a multi spool engine, maybe double spool or triple spool engine. That means, let's see. Now, the single spool, it has only one compressor, combustion chamber, and turbine. In double spool, the first compressor, as you see, we have dual spool. The first one here, many stages of compressor disc connected with a shaft inside the main shaft with a turbine. And then we have another compressor connected with the output shaft with a turbine. That means we have two shafts. The first one has the compressor and its turbine rotate with each other. This is built inside the main shaft. Between each shaft, we have a bearing. Between these shafts, we have a bearing to facilitate working, to facilitate movement. It is a duct. It has two parts, the compressor and three parts, the compressor, combustion chamber, and turbine. The first compressor connected with a shaft, internally shaft with its turbine. Okay? Then we have an external shaft. Compressor with internal shaft connected with its turbine. And here we have a compressor with external shaft connected with its turbine. The first spool, the first spool compressor, known as a low pressure compressor. Low pressure compressor. And the second spool or second stage of the compressor, known as a high pressure compressor. But in single stage compressor, as you see, we have only one compressor shaft, combustion chamber, and turbine. Between the two spools of the compressor, we have a combustion chamber.
ايش قال لي؟ We are having turbo load, trouble load. ما اعرف وش بالليف.
طيب. كومبرسر internal shaft turbine, compressor internal shaft turbine. The first stage of the compressor known as a low pressure compressor. And the second stage known as a high pressure compressor. The first section of the turbine known a high pressure turbine, while the second known as a low pressure turbine.
هو بالإثارة ولا بالسشن؟ خد نو بس.
عنا هون. The first compressor known a low pressure compressor connected with a low pressure turbine through a shaft, and a high pressure compressor connected with a high pressure turbine through a shaft. Normally, it is a compressor, combustion chamber, and turbine. This is a twin spool. It may be a triple spool compressor. Here we have a triple spool compressor. The first stage, low pressure compressor, connected with a low pressure turbine. The second stage compressor, connected with a second stage turbine. The third stage compressor, connected with a third stage turbine. The first one known is a low pressure compressor, connected with a low pressure turbine. The second one known as intermediate pressure compressor connected with the intermediate pressure turbine, and the high pressure compressor connected with a high pressure turbine. Dual and triple spool axial compressor were developed for the operation flexibility. الآن بنلاحظ احنا وين بكون مشبوك الشاف؟ بكون بس مع تيرباين او مع كومبرسر واحد, maybe three stages. But if we have a gas turbine engine with a long compressor, it is difficult to rotate through the starter. Okay, and it is a high compression ratio, a quick acceleration, better control for stall, and we'll talk about the stall independently. We have an engine known as a twin spool bypassed engine. Twin spool bypassed engine.
So gas turbine engine. Cylindrical duct consists of an inlet compressor and combustion chamber. The first stage of the compressor is connected through a shaft by a turbine. But here we have an engine core here. The first stage compressor connected with the low compressor connected with the low turbine. Okay, then we have a high pressure compressor connected with the high pressure turbine. Now, the incoming air from the atmosphere enters to the air inlet. Some of air enters through the low pressure compressor to the high pressure compressor, then to the combustion chamber bearing, and goes back to the turbine and strike the turbine at a proper angle to rotate the turbine, and the turbine rotates the compressor. After that, the gases goes back to the atmosphere. But some of this air will bypass the engine core through a duct and do not burn with the fuel, but it bypass the engine core, it goes back and mixed with the burned gases before or after it leaves the engine to the atmosphere. That means the first stage compressor, 50% of the incoming air, or maybe 60% of the incoming air, it does not burn and goes back or bypass the engine core to the exhaust at the same manner as a propeller. The compressor propels the air backward. This is the action. The aircraft will move forward. This is the reaction. This will help the burned gases to, when it leaves the engine to the atmosphere, to provide the engine with the thrust. It's a free thrust without burning the gases. Now, from that we have it may be low bypass or high bypass or intermediate bypass. حسب, it depends on the amount of the air that bypassed the engine core to the atmosphere. From this idea, we have an engine known as a turbofan engine or high bypass engine. Turbofan engine or high bypass engine. The turbofan engine, it is a gas turbine engine, cylindrical engine, has an air inlet, compressor and combustion chamber and turbine. The first stage compressor is a large fan connected with its turbine. After that, we have an engine core contained there. High pressure compressor. And high pressure turbine. Between them, we have a combustion chamber. Now, the turbofan engine, the air comes from the atmosphere, enter to the engine, 85% of incoming air bypass the engine core and goes back to the exhaust section at the same manner, it works at the same manner as a propeller. 65 to 85 of the incoming air bypass the engine core through a duct and then leaves the engine. It works in the same manner as a propeller. As the air goes back to the atmosphere without burning, as the air goes back to the atmosphere, this is the action. The aircraft will move forward. This is the action. Why 35 to 15 of air will enter the engine core through a high pressure compressor and burn inside the combustion chamber, goes back to the turbine, to the exhaust section, and leave the engine. This is the action. The aircraft will move forward. This is the reaction. This is the reaction. Before we reach to the end of our lecture, let us to talk about the types of the gas turbine engine. Types of the gas turbine engine. We have four types of gas turbine engine. We have four types of the gas turbine engine, which are the turbojet, turboprop, turboshaft, and turbofan engine. Turbojet, turboprop, turboshaft, and turbofan engine. The turbojet engine, the first one is turbojet engine. Turbojet engine in simple drawing, as you see, it is just a cylindrical duct. It has a compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, and exhaust. The thrust mainly depends on the burnt gases that leaves the engine. For reaction, there is an equal and opposite reaction. لكل فعل رد فعل مساو بالمقدار ومعاكس بالاتجاه. The second one is the turbofan engine. النوع الثاني اللي هو turbofan engine. اللي تكلم we talked about it. Before minutes. It is a cylindrical engine. It has a fan in front of the compressor. Here is the compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, and exhaust. In turbofan engine, 65 to 85 of the incoming air will leave the engine core and bypass the engine core and goes back to the atmosphere without burning. And 15 to 35 of the incoming air will enter the engine core and leaves the engine. 65 to 85 of the thrust depend on the air of the fan or fan air that leaves the engine core or bypass the engine core to the atmosphere at the same manner and of the propeller. 25 to 15 of the thrust comes from the burned gases. This known as a turbofan engine. It has a fan in front of the compressor. The third one is the turboprop engine. The turboprop engine is a gas turbine engine. It has a compressor, combustion chamber and turbine, but it has a large reduction gear in front of them to increase the torque and decrease the velocity of the output shaft connected with a propeller installed maybe at the wing or at the nose of the aircraft. The engine here or the burned gases here produce a little amount of thrust. A maximum 10% of the thrust comes from the burned gases, while 90% of the thrust depend on the propeller that installed in front of the engine. 15-10% فقط. The last one, and we'll talk about the turbo prop engine, turbo shaft, turbo jet engine. We'll talk about the, each of them independently. All of them has its own section. The last one is the turbo shaft engine. It's a gas turbine engine. So it's a gas turbine engine. It has a compressor. It has a compressor, combustion chamber, and turbine. But here it delivers the power to the output shaft, to a transmission, to drive something other than a propeller. It has a compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, and to throw a shaft, it delivers the power from the turbine to drive a transmission. The transmission drives the main rotor of the rotorcraft to the rotorcraft, to helicopter, to ship drive shaft, to oil pumps, generators, whatever. Here we have four types of the gas turbine engine: turbojet, turbofan, turboshaft, and turborope. This is the end of our lecture. Thank you for your good listening. Thank you. Emily, end.